Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I'm TWK of TWK Reviews, and I'm here to entertain you as your WCW World Heavyweight Wrestling Television Heavyweight Champion of the World of Professional Wrestling, the Earth, and the Moon. And welcome to my review of World Wrestling Federation SmackDown. Just Bring It, released for the PlayStation 2 in November 18, 2001, published by THQ and developed by Yuke's. This was basically an upgraded version of SmackDown 2 Know Your Role, and this is also one of the first wrestling games I honestly ever played in any real depth. When it comes to actually owning wrestling games, this is basically a first one for me, quite honestly. I mean, I should remember renting this at Blockbuster, and you remember Blockbuster those old days? truly, this was a different era. Anyways, I was there with my dad, and he was actually kind of hesitant about me renting this game because, of course, being a parent, he had probably heard all the horror stories about professional wrestling and how it would just warp my little mind. It would just destroy it. I couldn't handle it, obviously. However, he relented. He allowed me to rent it, and I have to thank him for that, because if not for that and playing through this game and eventually owning it, I honestly do not think that I would become as much of a fan of pro wrestling video games as I am today. And who knows, maybe I would have, but this is still the first game that I played at any real depth as far as wrestling games go. I mean, I played some of the games on N64, but I basically just borrowed those from my friends, and this is, like I said, this is the first one that I truly owned and played through on any real depth over and over and over again. So let's review this game, and hopefully it still holds up. Just Bring It has very arcadey gameplay, so expect much selling to be taking place in this game. The best way to sum up the type of game this is would be to steal a quote from Sonny Bone, who called it, "Race to the Finisher." And he isn't wrong in that assessment. Essentially, whoever hits their finisher first wins. I know that technically a lot of games use this sort of strategy, but SmackDown games were easily the most transparent about it. Also, if you haven't noticed, the pace of the game is about 1,000 times quicker than your average wrestling game. I guess I should eventually get around to how this game actually plays. X strikes, circle grapples, square reverses, triangle runs, R1 is your action button, R2 changes targets, L2 taunts, and L1 is your designated finisher button, and everything feels uber responsive. By the way, I really do miss the presentation of finishers. Seeing that SmackDown logo flying across the screen lets you know that somebody just got fucked up. The roster for this game is pretty rad, although I can see why a lot of people would be disappointed. When you consider the time the game was released, literally as the Invasion feud was ending, it's safe to assume that at least some of the big names would make it to the game. RVD? No. Booker T? No. Mike Awesome? DDP Canyon? No, no, and no. We did get Rhino, Alliance Steve Austin with the Disturbed theme, and this guy. Isn't it amazing that everyone that did make the cut somehow Jerry did? I'm not complaining, mind you, I'm just amazed. I don't even think he knows. Missing names aside, this roster is pretty jam-packed with star power. Now for the story mode. Replacing the season mode of Know Your Role, Just Bring It has a more streamlined mode, which consists of 1-3 matches with almost all paths leading to a title match. It's not too bad, but for those expecting something with a bit more depth, this may not be all that gratifying. I honestly don't mind it too much, and if nothing else, allows me to track championship reigns and basically play my own armchair booker, which is always fun. Now for the match types! There are a lot! Special referee, hardcore, and even this sorry excuse for Hell in a Cell. Yeah, this is a carryover from Know Your Role and not for the better. At least we can do Armageddon matches, which is all sorts of chaotic fun. Speaking of multi-man matches, this is still the only WWE game that I can think of that allows 8-man battle royals. If you thought the 6-man matches were insane, you haven't seen anything yet. There are ladder and TLC matches, although they can be over extremely quickly. There is a reason things change in the next game. As for career modes, this game can be a bit on the lacking side. There is Career Wrestler, but you're honestly better off not touching it, as the textures for the Career Wrestlers look like this. Just ugly. There's also Career Time, which is just weird. I was able to come up with this. It's a thing that exists for reasons.
Final thoughts. SmackDown Just Bring It is overall a fun arcade experience. Not the best, obviously. It has quite a few flaws, with the most obvious one that people love to bring up being the commentary. I didn't bring up in the review proper because I'm assuming all of you probably already know about that. In fact, I'm pretty sure the commentary is the first thing that comes to people's minds when they think about this game, so I didn't think it would honestly be necessary. I mean, seriously, it's been parodied to death, I'm sure. As far as my recommendation goes, if you're a hardcore wrestling fan and you just have to own every wrestling game, I can easily recommend it. However, if you're not someone who has to own everything, then I honestly recommend you skip this game and go straight to Shut Your Mouth. And I may actually review this game sometime in the future. Also, why did it take me this long to review any of the SmackDown games? Seriously, I've been doing these types of reviews for how long, and it took me this long to get to a SmackDown game? It's kind of ridiculous in my opinion. Anyways, until next time, this is TWK of TWK Reviews, telling you to work your gimmick! Now then, spin the wheel and make a deal!